As the U.S. COVID-19 death toll topped 291,000, a panel of outside advisors to the Food and Drug Administration late today has endorsed the emergency use of a Pfizer vaccine to save lives for those who are 16 years old or older. Its highly anticipated FDA approval would mean the biggest vaccination campaign in U.S. history could get underway in a matter of days. Amna Nawaz has the latest.
A pivotal step to clear one of the last hurdles before the U.S. approves its first COVID-19 vaccine.
The American public demands and deserves a rigorous, comprehensive, and independent review of the data.
In a day-long virtual meeting, an advisory panel to the Food and Drug Administration voted to recommend Pfizer's candidate for emergency approval. An FDA review already found it to be 95% effective.
Based on the totality of scientific evidence available, do the benefits of the Pfizer-BioNTech COVID-19 vaccine outweigh its risks?
Today's public debate on its safety with outside science and health experts was meant to build confidence in the process, discussing issues like whether trial participants who received a placebo should be offered the vaccine once approved.
Some participants at higher risk will want the vaccine as soon as it becomes available to them.
And potential new risks of the vaccine, like a few cases of allergic reactions reported in Britain.
There are tens of millions of people in this country who carry EpiPens with them because they have peanut allergies, because they have egg allergies, who are going to believe now that they can't get this vaccine. That's a lot of people.
A majority of Americans already stand behind it. A PBS NewsHour NPR Marist poll found 61% said they would get vaccinated. That's up from 49% in September. Still this morning, FDA Commissioner Dr. Stephen Hahn tried to appeal to Americans with remaining skepticism.
We need to vaccinate enough people to get herd immunity. I have 100% confidence, and I think the American public should as well, with respect to our review of the safety and efficacy of the vaccines.
Federal regulators could authorize the vaccine for distribution as early as Friday, clearing the way for an unprecedented inoculation process. Health and Human Services Secretary Alex Azar.
Product would ship within 24 hours. But here's the important thing. 20 million Americans could be vaccinated just before the end of this month in December. A total of 50 million Americans could be vaccinated by the end of January.
Welcome news in states like Virginia, where Governor Ralph Northam today imposed new restrictions.
Case numbers have been rising for weeks. They are now at record high levels. They're higher now than they ever have been during this entire pandemic.
The U.S. reported a new high of 3,000 deaths in the last 24 hours alone, and hospitalizations reached a record 106,000. Overwhelmed frontline healthcare workers are hoping the vaccine will alleviate some of that pressure.
Personally, I cannot roll up my sleeve fast enough to get this vaccination.
But Dr. Kamara Jones, a physician, epidemiologist, and past president of the American Public Health Association, warns the vaccine should not replace basic steps like masking, distancing, and hand washing.
It's a very good thing, but it's not going to be the answer even in 6 months. So right now, I am planning to keep my mask on for another year through December of 2021, at least.
For another year? That's
for
your
another
plan?
Year. Right now, what we have to do is mostly the public health stuff. That's the stuff that we have been able to do all along, but we did not fully implement.
All this amid new concerns about political pressure on the CDC. Congressman Jim Clyburn today said a CDC employee raised concerns about efforts by the Trump administration to destroy evidence of interference in the pandemic response.